Hello kind people, it's me Paul and welcome back to my YouTube channel. And for today's video, we're gonna answering the question, how to become an airline pilot in the Philippines? Or paano nga ba maging piloto sa Pilipinas? Since marami sa inyo or sa atin, especially sa mga kabataan yung gusto magpiloto. Pero they are quite unsure of all the processes na kailangan nilang gawin. And because of that, they are being discouraged. Kasi sabi ng iba, mahirap maging piloto. It's too complex to become an airline pilot. Ang pagpipiloto ay para lang sa matatalino. Ang pagpipiloto ay para lang sa mayayaman. So, I want to break those misconceptions in this video. Anyone can become an airline pilot. All I need you to do here is to believe. And by believing, it is more than enough for you to make that dream turn into reality. So if you are an aspiring pilot and just a random people who are curious in the processes on how to become an airline pilot, this video is perfectly for you. So keep watching and stay until the very end of this video. So without further ado, let's get started. First, let us differentiate the two kinds of pilot. So generally speaking, we have two kinds of pilot. The one who are in the military, where the aviation originally came from, we call them the Air Force pilot. And the other one who are in the business field for the commercial plane, we call them the airline pilot. So we're gonna focusing on the process on how to become an airline pilot, obviously. What are the requirements ba on how to become an airline pilot? First, you have to have a 4-year degree course and you have to have a flying hours. For us to understand more of those things, ano nga bang college course yung kailangan kong kunin? Ba yung flying hours na yon? How can I get that flying hours? Saan ko kukunin yung mga flying hours na yon? So, these two pointers will help us to understand those things. Number one, what should I do after grade 12? And what should I do after college? Alright, so let's get into the first pointer. Kuya Paul, what should I do after grade 12? After grade 12, you have to enroll yourself in a college or in a university. Philippine State College of Aeronautics offers Bachelor of Science in Air Transportation, major in Advanced Flying, for free. Sabi ko nga, that hits two birds in one stone. Pero Kuya Paul, balita ko, yung pagpasok sa BSAT mahirap. Paano pag hindi po ako natanggap? So wala pong problema doon. It doesn't necessarily mean naman na kapag gusto mo magpiloto, yung course na kukunin mo sa 4 years degree course mo, bachelor's mo, is in line with aviation. It doesn't require that. It doesn't necessarily mean niya ganon. You can enroll as a student of civil engineering, architecture, psychology, medical field, or so on and so forth. Wala pong problema yun. Kuya Paul, paano yun? Nasa medical field ako. Paano ako makakapagpalipad ng aeroplano? To answer that question, here goes to the second pointers. What should I do after college? So, isihan lang natin. Although, madami yung proseso, pero iisihan lang natin yan. So, after college, you have to enroll in a flight school. So, sa Pampanga, meron tayong Alpha Aviation Group, Omni Aviation, etc., etc. If you are in Subic or in Longapo, there's Laminar Aviation there. Kuya Paul, ano po ba yung meron dun sa flight school na yon? Sa flight school na yon, you will acquire their SPL, PPL, CPL, IR, FIC, and ATPL. Ano yung SPL, PPL, CPL, chuchu, blah, blah, ng ATPL na yan? Those are the licenses po na meron ang mga piloto. SPL stands for Student Pilot License, PPL for Private Pilot License, CPL for Commercial Pilot License, IR is for Instrument Rating, FIC, these are just optional. If you want to become a flight instructor, you will have a flight instructor license, and as well as the Air Transport Pilot License. So yun po yung meaning ng mga yun. Kuya Paul, kailangan ko ba yung mga yun? Yes po. So, paano po sila kukunin? Let's start with SPL. Ang SPL po, or Student Pilot License, is automatic na mabibigay sa inyo once you will enroll in any of the flight schools. Ang flight school nyo na po ang pupunta sa CAAP, or Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines, para asikasuhin ang inyong Student Pilot License. Kuya Paul, after ko po makuha yung SPL, ano na? So, we will proceed in the Private Pilot License. Kuya Paul, ano po yung mga requirements for me to get the Private Pilot License? So, you will have to have a ground schooling, a flight simulator training, and 40 hours of flying. Kuya Paul, ano pong gagawin dun sa ground schooling? Ground schooling, from the word itself, you will be in the classroom. So pag-aaralan nyo doon yung basic principle of flying, basic principle in aviation, aerodynamics, theory of lights, Bernoulli's principle, so yung mga ganong klaseng bagay. So if you have taken the aviation related courses nung college, that is your advantage. Kasi hindi ka na mahihirapang intindihin yun. Pero kapag naman hindi ka galing sa aviation related na course, that is very very important for you to know. After nun, Kuya Paul, what is flight simulator training? From the word itself, flight simulator. Later, flight simulator is like this. No, so para siyang, yeah, ayan. Para siyang totoong eroplano. Pero hindi pa siya totoo. I hope you get it. So Kuya Paul, after flight simulator, ano na pong gagawin? So after flight simulator, you will be now in the actual flying. So you will fly together with your flight instructor, tuturuan ka niya before your first solo flight. You have a private pilot license, kailangan may 40 flying hours ka muna. So Kuya Paul, paano yun? So every 1 hour is equivalent to 1 flying hours. So that is equivalent to 40 hours of flying from the word itself. Ang tanong ngayon, Paul, magkano yon? Magkano ang buong private pilot license course or private pilot course? Sa amin na aviation, yung rating nila is nasa 13,000 per hour. You will need a 40 flying hours for you to get a private pilot license. So you will have to have a 520,000 pesos para magkaroon ka ng private pilot license. Plus, yung gagastusin mo sa ground schooling and sa flight simulator. So that's about 150,000. So you will have to have a less than 700,000 pesos for you to get a private pilot license. But do not be discouraged kasi merong paraan paano makakakuha yan. Easier way. So didiscuss ko yun sa inyo mamaya. Huwag kayong madi-discourage. Okay? Next, Kuya Paul, merong CPL. Ano po yung CPL na yun? So that's commercial pilot license. What does requires us for us to get that? So you have to have a 200 flying hours. So kayo na po mag-compute doon, 13,000 times 200 flying hours. So that's about 2.6 million pesos for you to have that commercial pilot license. After that, kakaroon pa kayo ng instrument rating. Another bayad po yon. Or if you want to become a flight instructor, you will enroll yourself to a flight instructor course. So another bayad na naman yon. So if you will have to sum all those up hanggang sa FIC or flight instructor course, so probably ang gagastusin mo dun is nasa 3.2 million pesos if I'm not mistaken. After that FIC, ano na pong gagawin, Kuya Paul? So, it is now time for you to have your Airbus type rating or any type rating. If you want Boeing type rating or Airbus type rating for you to get into the airline. Kasi ire-require po yan ng airline. Paano po ba yung Airbus type rating na yun, Kuya Paul? If you want to fly an Airbus A380, A320, A330, nasa sa inyo po yun. Parang yun sa mga lisensya natin sa motor or sa sasakyan. Naka-specify doon kung anong klaseng sasakyan lang yung pwede nating imaneho. Ganun din sa pagpipiloto. So, kung ang nasa lisensya mo, ang nasa Airbus type rating mo is Airbus A330, yun lang po yung specific na airplane or aircraft na po pwede mong paliparin. Ang lisensya mo, A320 na Airbus type rating, hindi ka po pwede magpalipad ng 330 or any other aircraft. Basta A320 lang. So that's another training po, that's another expenses kasi ang paliliparin nyo po sa flight school is Cessna, ang paliliparin nyo na po sa airline is wide-bodied aircraft, mas malalaking aircraft po. So, a rough estimation for you to have the ATPL or Air Transport Pilot License is around 4 to 5 million pesos. Paul, kayo po ba? Yung family po ba ninyo may 4 to 5 million pesos po ba kayo? Actually, wala. Pero Kuya Paul, bakit you are like quite confident na makakapagpiloto ka, wala naman palang 4 to 5 million pesos? Simply, I just put my confidence to God. And confidence in Him na He will provide for my needs. He has everything. There are easier way naman on how to become an airline pilot. So hindi naman necessarily mean na kapag gusto mo magpiloto, kailangan meron kang 4 to 5 million pesos. Hindi, kasi may mga paraan po on how to get that. What are those, Kuya Paul? meron po tayong first tinatawag na SNPL or Study Now Pay Later Program. Ano po yung Study Now Pay Later Program na yun, Kuya Paul? Meron pong mga aviation company or mga airlines as well na nagsha-shoulder na po ng inyong trainings from the start, from ab initio up until magkaroon kayo ng trabaho. Paano yun? Sila na po yung magbabayad ng paggagastos ninyo sa SPL, sa PPL, sa CPL, sa IR, FIC if you would love to, and sa ATPL ninyo. Hanggang sa magkaroon na po kayo ng trabaho. So, it's like a scholarship, pero babayaran nyo po yun kapag nagtatrabaho na po kayo. Kaya siya naging Study Now, Pay Later. If I'm not mistaken, they will get a 20% of your salary every month until you will fulfill yung nagastos po ninyo doon sa program. Pero it's a good thing na naging piloto ka na, di ba? Wala nang problema yun, at least piloto ka na. Are you getting that? So sana na-gets nyo po yung Study Now, Pay Later program. Kuya Paul, ano pa po yung ibang ways on how to get into becoming an airline pilot? Yung iba po, nag-Air Force po sila. Kasi sa Air Force po, meron po silang free, may scholarship po sila doon. No, you have to pass the exam doon sa Air Force kung gusto nyo pong maging piloto. Tapos, libre po yun. All the way from ab initio to again Airbus type rating for you to have as well. The Air Transport Pilot License. Yung iba naman, nagpa-flight instructor sila. They will get first the flight instructor course. Tapos habang nagpapalipad sila, binabayaran sila ng flight school and at the same time, nakaka-gain sila ng flying hours. Or kunwari ako, flight instructor nyo ko. So, yung flying hours ninyo, nakasama ako na nagpapalipad, napupunta din sa akin. At the same time, binabayaran din ako ng flight school. So, ganun po nag-work yun. Maraming ways. No? Huwag lang tayong mapagod kakahanap ng mga paraan on how to become an airline pilot. And at the end, if it is our passion, hindi naman tayo mapapagod talaga na maghanap ng paraan. So, huwag lang tayong tamad, huwag lang tayong mapagod. Ganun man, we just have to put our confidence in God. We just have to believe that God will provide. And at the same time, gagalaw po tayo. We submit it to God. Surely, we will use people to bless us for us to get there. Because we are designed to be there. Yung mga aeroplanong paliliparin natin, gawa na. Tayo na lang yung hinihintay. That's it for today's video, I guess. If you have any more questions, if you have any request, just put it in the comment section below and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more quality content. So again, this is Paul. Thank you guys and see you on the next video. Bye!